नेपोलियन।
हाय फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट नेपोलियन फ्रॉम 1769 टू 1821 एंड द सिविल कोड ऑफ 1804। नेपोलियन इंट्रोड्यूस्ड मेनी रिफॉर्म्स टू सिंप्लीफाई द एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन एंड टू मेक द होल सिस्टम मोर एफिशिएंट। Napoleon was the self-dictated leader of France, who was a military commander initially. Later, in 1799, by becoming the first consul, so Napoleon was the ruler of France. Napoleon was the self-dictated leader of France, who was a military commander initially. Later. In 1799, by becoming the first consul, Napoleon introduced many reforms to simplify the administration and to make the whole system more efficient. His revolutionary principles were called Civil Code of 1804, usually known as the Napoleonic Code. So there are two names for the changes which are introduced by Napoleon. The name one, Civil Code of 1804, and it is also popularly known as the Napoleonic Code of 1804. Napoleon ruled France from 1799 to 1815. He assumed absolute power in 1799 by becoming the first consul. Simplification of administrative divisions, the improvement in transport and communication system, the removal of trade guild restrictions, standardization of weights and measures, and introduction of common currency were the major changes in the system which are introduced by Napoleon. What are the major changes that are introduced by Napoleon? He simplified the administrative divisions. He improved the transport and the communication system. He removed the trade guild restrictions and standardization of weights and measures. And he also introduced the common currency. So these are the few major changes which were introduced through the Napoleonic Code. The right to property was also secured. The code established equality before law and abolished all privileges based on birth. The key point of the Napoleonic Code is equality before law and abolishing all the privileges based on birth. This code was exported to the regions of Switzerland, Italy, and Germany. The Napoleonic Code was also exported to the regions of Switzerland, Italy, and Germany. It also abolished the feudal system and freed the peasants from serfdom. So it abolished the feudal system and it also gave freedom for the peasants from serfdom and the manorial dues. Taxation and censorship were imposed and military services were made mandatory. So the other changes which were brought to the Napoleonic Code were abolition of feudal system, freed peasants from serfdom, taxation and censorship were imposed, military services are made compulsory for every citizen of the French nation. French armies were welcomed as the symbols of liberty in Brussels, Mainz, Milan and Warsaw. So most of the European regions welcomed the French armies as a symbol of liberty, especially in Brussels, Mainz, Milan and Warsaw. The people began hostile due to increased taxation, censorship, post conscription into the French armies. Now, initially, the French armies were welcomed, but now they became hostile due to increased taxation on them, censorship on them, and they are forced to join the French armies. This all made the people of Milan, Brussels, Warsaw to become hostile towards the French army or the French rule. So finally, here are the pointers what we learned today. The Civil Code of 1804, usually known as the Napoleonic Code, he did away with all the privileges based on birth and established equality before the law and secured the right to property. Napoleon simplified administrative divisions. He abolished the feudal system and freed peasants from serfdom and manorial due. In the towns, too, guilds restrictions were removed. Transport and communication system were improved. Peasants, artisan workers, and new businessmen enjoyed a newfound freedom. So these are the key points of Napoleonic Code. Thank you.